Yeah, thank you. I think. Please, because I can't, you know, I can't see. Okay. So, good evening. Good evening, dear friends. Thank you for coming over at a very short notice. Your colleagues and friends in Delhi are very upset with me. Of course, I can see some of them here because yesterday they were all trying to reach me and I was not able to speak to the media in Delhi yesterday. So I'm sure they would be very upset, but there will be other opportunities to speak to them. So I want to be very brief and I'm not really planning to make any, you know, major announcements or anything like that because it needs time for me to settle down to study all the issues. I just want to mention a few points. First, you know, you would be aware that I assumed charge today in the morning as the 25th governor, and I am grateful for all the good wishes which I have received from many of you who are present here. The RBI is a great institution. It has got a very long legacy, a very rich legacy, and I will do everything that is possible. I will, you know, I'll try and uphold the professionalism, the core values, the credibility and the autonomy of the Reserve Bank as an institution. I have interacted at various levels with the officials of the Reserve Bank of India over the last 10 years or more than 10 years. And the interaction has been not only at the senior levels but also at the middle level and even down the line. And I was also, there were situations where I was leading delegations from Government of India, which included officers from Reserve Bank of India. And I always found that they possess inherent core competence and professionalism to deal with any technical issue, be it monetary aspects or be it other aspects of currency management or other aspects of work relating to the functioning of a central bank. So I'm looking forward to work with the entire team of officers and staff of the Reserve Bank of India. Now, it's a great opportunity for any individual and especially for me to work in RBI and thereby to serve the country. That might sound a bit cliched, but it is indeed a great opportunity. And I will work as a team with other officials here to, in the best interest of the economy, and try and take measures in a timely manner on issues, on aspects which the economy requires or which are in the best interest of the Indian economy. Decision making in the modern times have become very complex. Today we are living in a very dynamic world. It's much more dynamic than what it was, say, 5 years ago or 10 years ago is a long period in the past, but even 3 years or 5 years ago, decision making in today's world has become far more complex. And consultation with stakeholders is very important. Consultation with all the stakeholders always adds value to our understanding of issues. It adds depth to our understanding of issues. So therefore, I propose to undertake consultations wherever necessary as per requirement in a need-based manner on various issues. To begin with, I have convened a meeting with the MD and CEOs of the MDs and the CEOs of the public sector banks tomorrow in the morning. And as you know, banking is an important segment of our economy and it's currently facing several challenges which are of critical importance and they need to be dealt with. There have been, I'm not implying in any manner that nothing has been done. A lot has been done. A lot has been done both by the government and by the Reserve Bank of India. Several measures have been taken, but many more measures also perhaps need to be taken. So tomorrow morning, I propose to undertake a consultation with the MDs and CEOs of the public sector banks who are based in Mumbai. Then immediately after that, maybe after another few days, I'll hold a consultation with the chiefs of public sector banks which are located outside Mumbai, because You cannot expect people who are outside Mumbai to come at such a short notice. Then subsequently, at some stage, I will have an interaction with the private sector banks also to understand the issues relating to them. So on the whole, it's a banking sector which I would like to focus immediately, but this will be followed by other kind of stakeholder consultations as may be required. There are a number of issues ahead. We have, of course, as you know, the after the amendment of the Reserve Bank of India Act, the inflation targeting continues to be very important. And it's very heartening to note that the inflation, broadly, it is as per the targets. And the inflation outlook also looks fairly benign at this stage. But we have to be very watchful of the developments. The issue of health of public sector banks, I have already mentioned, that's an important issue. The issue of liquidity also comes up in the media space and in the public space from time to time. There again, I think that will be an area where one has to interact with stakeholders and get an internal feedback and then take a view on these issues. The maintenance of the growth trajectory of the Indian economy is also important. And so there are several areas which a central bank has to be dealing with. And so we will focus on those areas. And all these issues have been under focus. Let me make it very clear. It's not as if these areas did not receive any attention. I want to be very clear that all these aspects have been receiving focus. But it's a continuing exercise on the part of the central bank. So therefore, we will continue to focus on these areas. And you may be aware that the central board meeting is scheduled to be held on the 14th of December. So we will hold the central board meeting as planned and have go through the agenda and discuss the various issues that are listed. And I must also, before I conclude, like to make note of the stewardship provided by my predecessor, Dr. Urjit Patel, to the Reserve Bank of India in the last 2.5 years. And I would like to also convey my best wishes to Dr. Urjit Patel for all his future endeavors. So thank you. I'll stop here.
So I'll just take
very few questions because, as I mentioned earlier,
one word on governance.
I'll start here and come back. Yes.
Sir, I would like to know that there is a view that the RBI management should be accountable to the RBI board. And many important decisions should be there in the board. The board should have many committees. This is the view from the government, which the RBI under the previous governor's regime resisted, protested. What is your view on the issue of governance for RBI, which is a very important issue that will be discussed on the board meeting on 14th?
No, I would not like to go into what were the issues or what are the issues between government, which is an important, which runs the country, and the Reserve Bank of India. But every institution, every institution has to have its professional integrity, maintain its professional autonomy. At the same time, every institution also must adhere to principles of accountability.
The Reserve Bank's capital has been a contentious issue. What are your views? Do you expect the committee to take a call before the fiscal year is out?
No, let the committee be constituted. I think, as you are aware, the committee has to be constituted, and I think very shortly the committee will be constituted. And then the terms of reference of the committee will draw up. So that will spell out how much time is required. We'll have to consult whoever becomes the chairman of the committee. He has to be consulted before we fix a timeline.
Sir, if I may ask a question, you are coming to RBI as the 25th governor under unprecedented circumstances. If I may ask you a very frank and a candid and maybe a little blunt question, the relationship between the central government and the central bank has hit rock bottom. Will your priority be to first fix that relationship before some of the issues that you've listed out? The channels of communication seemingly are blocked.
No, I don't know about, what is blocked and whether the relationship is not, not good, or I won't like to go into that. But as I mentioned, that we have to have stakeholder consultation. We'll have to have consultation with everybody. Government is ultimately the government has an, government is not just a stakeholder, but I mean, the government of the day runs the economy, runs the country, and manages major policy decisions. So there has to be free, fair, objective, and very frank discussion with between the government and the Reserve Bank of India. And I would like to believe that all issues, howsoever contentious, can be resolved through discussions.
Governor,
I'll just come.
This side, please, Governor.
The February 12th circular, which was, of course, one big bone of contention. What is your view? You think there could be some kind of step back from?
No, views on individual issues, I would not. Let me, I have to really settle down, study the issues, and then take a view.
Governor, dialogue, because there has been none from RBI and the government.
Yeah. My personal views on these matters, on these things would not matter. What I have to really see and understand issues before I start commenting, because every observation made by the central bank has got, a lot of wide-ranging impact. So let me understand the issues. So I would not like to go in details. Yeah. देखिए पीसीए के साथ ही एक जनरल कंसल्टेशन है, मतलब कल के लिए कोई ऐसा फिक्स्ड एजेंडा नहीं रखा है. बैंकिंग जो सेक्टर है हमारे इकोनॉमी का एक बहुत बड़ा इम्पॉर्टेंट विंग ऑफ द इकोनॉमी. तो उनके साथ इट्स अ जनरल कंसल्टेशन टू सॉर्ट ऑफ ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड देयर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ नॉट जस्ट द बैंकिंग सेक्टर बट ऑल्सो हाउ द इकोनॉमी इज फंक्शनिंग. It's a general interaction with the banks.
Sir, just to follow up, Governor, you'll be meeting with the heads of PSU banks tomorrow, as soon as tomorrow. Are you open to discussing, easing of capital requirements for these banks?
I will not reply to this question with reference to, I will not reply to your question specifically with reference to that, because the moment I say that, I am okay with this, then you will put a different headline. Please take it from me. It's not with reference to your question. I'm open to discussing all issues.
Governor, this is Suvashree from
Governor, on the issue, you spoke about growth. On the issue of credit flow to the economy, both to the SME sector and the credit that was growing from NBFCs, which has been constrained. Do you think both of those are risks to growth, which the RBI under you would like to tackle?
I mean, these are all what you have mentioned are challenges, various challenges which the economy today faces, and all those challenges which come in the domain of the central bank naturally will receive the attention of the Reserve Bank of India.
Governor,
what is the issue, sir?
Governor, inflation is expected to go below 3% later in the evening. What's your view on interest rates and inflation if inflation goes below
3%? No, there is a monetary policy committee which has to decide. And inflation target, as I mentioned, let me make it very clear, inflation targeting is a very important component of the RBI's functioning, and it's a function which the Monetary Policy Committee has to fulfill. I cannot jump the gun and make a statement at this point.
Yeah. Suvashree from Reuters. Governor, I wanted to understand what is your view about growth implications going ahead in terms of the growth momentum. Do you expect growth momentum to slow down going ahead? Is that a bigger focus for you now, given that inflation momentum is slowing down? Thank you.
No, and I have mentioned that inflation targeting is an important function which the Reserve Bank of India Act, the government, the law which has mandated. It's a mandatory requirement of, it's a mandatory part of the RBI's functioning. So that will remain very important. And issue of growth, I did mention, yes, I agree. And let us also keep in mind that this is a part of, if you read the, I'm not bringing anything which is extraneous to the RBI Act. If you see the preamble of the RBI Act, which talks about the Monetary Policy Committee, it also says that keeping in mind the requirements of growth. So I am not saying anything which is beyond the Reserve Bank of India Act.
But does that mean that you will promote, you will boost, help take growth measures, growth supportive measures?
No, what measures we will take?
I mean, are you in favor of promoting growth supportive measures?
What measures we will take, that you will know only when, you know, some decision is
taken. I'm not asking for measures, sir.
Sir Bijoy from Cogensis here. So you start, you're starting your tenure with meeting with the PSU banks. Financial sector has been an issue. Financial services sector has been an issue. We have had ILNFS. You have entities that are governed by you taking you to court. You have private sector banks that are now headless because the RBI has taken a tough stance on many of them. And you have 11 banks under PCA from the PSU banks. Is that going to be an area of focus, especially from the fact that you need to clarify on various financial sector regulations because of these kind of legal challenges that are being thrown at you now?
You see, life is never simple. There are always multiple challenges. So we'll deal with them as we go by. We'll deal with all the issues that are, you know, which, as I said, which come in the domain of the Reserve Bank of India. So,
Sir, India News se Abhishek Sharma. सर एक सवाल है आम आदमी जिस तरह से आप नए गवर्नर आए हैं आम आदमियों के लिए क्या खास होगा क्योंकि सब लोग खास ये जान चाहते हैं कि हमारे घर के रेट कब कम होंगे यानी इंटरेस्ट रेट अब क्या नए गवर्नर साहब लोगों के लिए नई सौगात लेकर आएंगे नए
आपका सवाल का जवाब थोड़ी देर पहले मैंने दिया था वो MPC है मॉनिटरी पॉलिसी कमेटी उसमें जो फैसला होगा आपको जब वो जो अगले मीटिंग जब भी ड्यू है आपको पता लग जाएगा
प्लीज़
I have mentioned right in the beginning that, I will sort of uphold the autonomy and the integrity and the, the credibility of the Reserve Bank of India as an institution. And I would believe that the autonomy and, independence of the RBI as an institution is very important and it will be intact.
Sir, now.
One minute. नहीं ऐसे कोई मतलब मैं उस जो एक पॉलिटिकल डिबेट है उसके तहत में नो उसके बारे में मैं कुछ नहीं कहना चाहता हूँ वो जो पॉलिटिकल डिबेट है वो अलग जगह होता है सो उसके बारे में आई वुड नॉट लाइक टू से एनीथिंग यस प्लीज You see, if I don't speak about it, then the interpretation is would be that, you know, I have completely sort of, since I have a background in the government, so therefore I have, so I thought let me make the, you know, the ground rules very clear. So that's why I mentioned, and this is a question which I think in the, if you see the, I mean, over the past few, I think over the last 2-3 days and in the media, there's been a lot of talk. So I knew there will be questions about that. So I thought कि आपका जो question है before the question comes let me address it.
लेकिन सर
what is your view on the farm debt waiver schemes? Earlier RBI and your predecessors.
No, at this point I would not like to give views on all aspects of this thing. I'll stop here. Thank you. No, later on. Thank you very much for all your patience. And we will be.
Deputy Governor still there?
And we will. Sorry.
Is Deputy Governor Acharya still there?
I had tea with him some time ago. So as far as I know, he is very much there. Thank you very much.
The news broken to you and by whom?